And I got back with Dr. Dre, mm-hmm. with the Chronic 2001, mm-hmm. and that did like seven. But you see what I'm saying? Like, it's moments where you don't, you can't watch the numbers.
Yes.
Because if you watch the numbers, you'll believe that, man, I fell off. Man.
Yes.
You ain't fell off.
No.
It's somebody else that then came, like mm-hmm. you came. Yes. Now you got to work harder.
Yes.
When you first come, it's just you. And after you, it's a hundred niggas that's just like you. Because you're making people that want to be like you right now.
Sure.
That's what you got to know.
Yeah.
And you can't be mad.
Yeah, you can't. You can't.
When you see a nigga looking just like you, sounding you like you.
You can't. Like if I call me there, like everybody like.
Because you are what's right. You fashionably correct. Mm. All my homies was gangbangers. They was real gangbangers and drug dealers. But when I started rapping, they slowly but surely put their rags down, put their dope sacks down. I'm going to be a manager. I'm going to be a producer. I'm going to be a rapper. Hey, cause I'm getting in. Some way, I'm getting in this motherfucking rap game. And I changed the perspective of not only my neighborhood, but niggas on the West Coast. Rapping was cool, but it wasn't for everybody. When Snoop Dogg came, he made gangbangers feel like they could rap. Real gangbangers. Not the ones that was in the studio, but the ones that really had criminal records. And you know what I'm saying? Because that's who I was, and that's who I fucked with. So when I made it, I put niggas in the game that had real criminal records, which reflected, man, I could change. Because I was in jail, because I was locked up with that nigga.
Yeah.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
And where you from, you really inspirational. You talking about Tanzania, Africa?
Yes.
Yeah, please.